All right. I have not previously watched this. Double jab, like, there's a few things you can do, but I don't do, like, landing enough. He just landed. I'm assuming that's intentional. He could have, like, STI'd up and then jumped out, for example, or done something else, but he decided to just land, and he just got grabbed for it, so... Oh my gosh. That's so annoying how, like, you're, like, so close. Look how close that is, and you can, like, not shield... I think the down tilt, like, it. She can't crouch under Falcon's grab, but she can at a certain spacing from if she down tilts. Like, if you try and grab her and she's, like, still in the down tilt animation, you, like, can't grab it sometimes. It's kind of weird. That's something, like, I think the Falcon's got to be more cognizant of, but it's pretty difficult because it feels very shield grabbable instinctively, you know? This percent's rough because, like, everything just connects at this percent, basically. You're supposed to DI away on dash attack, generally. Was that a full DI away? It might have been. I'm not sure if that was a full DI away, but, like, you should full DI away. But even if you do, you're still in a bad spot, so there's, like, not much you can do. That's the thing about this matchup. There's so much, like, zero-to-deathing and, like, huge kills off of one hit. Both these characters can zero-to-death each other pretty hard, so... I think that full hop up air was risky. I don't really think this full hop up air was worth, even if it hit, because then, like, Plup might slide off, and then just you can't follow up, and then if he shields, he's going to get shield drop fared. So I think that should have just been a short hop up air. Plup always does a run up tilt. It's like no other Sheik really does it that much, so it's kind of weird to be used to. That was actually really tricky. I'm trying to think. He might have been able to shield drop up air, the up air from Sheik right here. Yeah, I think so. But he was like, Plup was drifting away to try to avoid it anyway. I feel like, I noticed S2J, he's not as like shield drop happy as most other Falcons, which I think is a good thing overall, but there are times where he could just shield drop up air instead of what he chooses. But I think it's like a good thing overall that he's not a shield drop happy, but there's times where he could probably just shield drop up air. Yeah, see the dash attack? Oh, I can't believe that didn't connect. That was good. That up air was crucial. He could have hit that. That was crucial. Punishes are so severe in this matchup. It really does feel like you got to hit your punishes more than ever. Because, like, versus Fox and Falco, a lot of times, like, it's usually, like, two or three interactions before one of the sides kill each other. In Falcon Sheik, it can be one or two interactions. It's crucial in every matchup, obviously, but it's really dire versus Sheik, I guess. I think Plup likes to needle more neutral than the other Sheiks, which it seems good. So it's kind of annoying to deal with. It doesn't seem like Falco lasers either, where you can just like crouch it. Doesn't seem to work as well. Sheik also edgeguards Falcon really well, and vice versa. So, surprised he didn't stomp here, actually. I feel like that was an S2J stomp moment. That was a big opener. I guess the double jump was just risky in general. Ooh, that could have been shield grab, but it was like a really quick reaction. Ooh. I was thinking maybe he would jab reset there. That's more of an optional thing though, but he didn't get to finish the tech chase, so that he just like basically lost that potential punish. The wrong guess, I guess. This is the thing, like nairing versus a low percent Sheik is like really, really risky. But that is such a smart way to contest it, actually. Just crouching there and down tilt? That's crazy, actually. I didn't realize it was that easy for Sheik to, like, do something like that versus it. Yeah. Sheik is, like, tiny, basically. Oh, that was nice. I like that one better. The few punishes S2J has gotten, it feels like he's gotten, like, nothing off it. So this stomp is big. Although he teched in place, that's really kind of hard. Most people don't do that, so I can't blame him. So he could have grabbed that technically, I'm pretty sure, but that is, I don't blame him for missing that. Plup is just really good. No one's going to tech in place there besides him, probably. Interesting. There's actually another situation. This is really smart by Plup, but like I think he could have shield dropped up air, but there's another situation where SUJ is not as shield drop happy as the other Falcons. He does something, he wave dashes at his shield rather than shield drop, and that just so happened to work perfectly. So I think if he did like a perfect shield drop up air, he would have won. It's weird though, because I feel like I shield drop too much versus Plup, but he's not shield dropping enough versus Plup, so it's kind of weird. Maybe Plup is just aware of the style difference really well, or maybe it's just a coincidence. Oh, man, Plup is just doing everything right. This up air, he slid off. SJ was expecting him to get popped up, so he just, now he's in a terrible spot. Lesson learned from this first game, expect Plup to do everything right. That should have been up air. Good. I like the down tilt, actually. I think down tilt's a little underrated. And it's cool. Actually, that's cool. He wanted to down tilt. It's just funny. He literally wave dashed at a shield and down tilted. Like, that was a lot, just a down tilt. But that was, it worked out perfectly. This is just rough. One hit and he's dead, so. It's actually good he's not shield grabbing. The up tilt would beat the shield grab. His matchup is Sheik favored? Yeah. I don't think it's Sheik favored by a lot necessarily, but I think on a human level, it might be more than slightly Sheik favored. It's kind of hard to say. Like, it's really hard to fight a really good, consistent Sheik in this matchup. It's a really consistent matchup for Sheik, I feel like, so it's really hard. At least versus Fox and Falco, it's also really hard, and they're probably harder, but it's easier to, like, get a cheese kill or, like, them play a little bit off and you get away with it, you know? Versus Sheik, there's not, you really just have to play solid all around. There's not much room for, like, oh, I'm playing a little bit off or something. Yeah, I would say this matchup's like 55-45 Sheik favored, but on a human level, it's more like 60-40, I feel like. So take that as you will. Because I consider Fox and Falco like 60-40, give or take. Completely separate 60-40s, but around there. This is such a rough spot, though. Oh, yeah, I was looking at why he got jabbed, what had a shield option he chose. I think he just jumped. It's just so rough. What can you do there? Like, just wait for the jab, basically? So he jab one. You just have to wait for the jab, but then he could jab two. So it's like, it just covers a lot of, kind of like a 50-50. This is the other thing. The top Sheiks are so good at crouch canceling. Even if you get a hit that's not like Nair, that seems like it should be safe, they can just crouch cancel it. So he did an up air, he dashed back, he did like everything perfectly, but like, it just feels like nothing's truly safe for Sheik at low percent unless you get like a stomp or a grab, but like, you can't only do stomp and grab or else you're not going to get in. Good knee. Those low percent openers are really, powerful versus Sheik because she crouch cancels so much of Falcon stuff at low percent. That sucks. Can't have that happen. That was kind of weird. Ooh. Yeah, so it seems like if Sheik gets, like, the landing needle like this, like, you're just stuck in shield. Kind of like a shine or something. Kind of like a Nair shine from Fox or something. Up tilt. So, that is crazy. I really like that down tilt. I like S2J's using down tilt, because I feel like I've been using down tilt more, and I think it's underrated. So I think we probably both think that. Good. Is this? Did he miss the L cancel? Or I guess it's an awkward spot regardless. Ooh, good. I like that bear. Ooh. I would have done like a get up or roll or... What would I have done here? I probably would have done like a roll or get up attack, but whatever. Oh, he could have got a grab there, I feel like. I feel like that was a grab spot. Grab. Grab. Both of those I felt like were grab spots. Ooh. I think it was good because he like jumped and then he didn't drift forward with it. So he baited him to like as if he was going to drift forward and he didn't. See, watch. Looks funny, actually. See, he jumped, and usually Falcons just jump towards center stage here, but he just, like, jumped in place without any drift. So Plup missed the fair. So he actually whiff punished him for that, so that was perfect. And now this could be an edge guard, but it's kind of hard. Okay. Transformations. Probably should just get out of there. It's a rough spot. I feel like he should just get out of here. Like, Sheik is just repressive in this corner. I was going to say stomp, but that's also like an insanely risky, nonsensical stomp almost. So I think he should just focus on getting the center. Like, when you're in this corner and this, like, can you see my mouse? This little, like, Falcon's foot, that little ledge, not the ledge, but the little black line next to Falcon's foot, that is like annoying, so it makes it hard to just dash to center and stuff, and or dash or roll to center. He kind of has to just jump over here. This is like This is like a crappy spot because he's in the corner, but this black line makes it extra crappy because the collision is weird. So like, if you try to roll, you won't go to center. You'll just get stuck on it. I mean, I guess he did actually kind of try to go to center, to be fair. I was thinking double jump, but that's also kind of risky, so I can't really blame him for that. He did kind of try to go. Okay. See, like, right here is what I'm talking about. Like, she tried to do something. She got stuck on the little black line lip thing I was talking about, so it's hard to get out. That corner is annoying. Not a fun corner. Okay. Oh, that saved him, actually. Wow, how did this... Let's see how this saved him. They rolled... Pokemon transformations coming to save, I guess. Is that it? Was it right here? Ooh, that is Pokemon transformation coming to save the day. I guess it didn't matter. Oh, it's save the day again. Okay. Let's go transformation. That's, oh man. What do you do here? Roll. The instant rolls are kind of getting them into trouble, but I can't blame them. I would do the same thing. I like to jump away. Doing better versus the double jabs now. He DI'd it better too. Ooh. So apparently you can shield grab the up tilt, but I swear it's like fucking impossible. It's like a frame perfect shield grab or something close. So it's just something we have to practice, shield grabbing the up tilt, because it is like so fucking hard to shield grab. And it feels really bad to like give up on it. So I don't know if that's the answer either. I need to look more into that. Apparently it's possible. Chef Rockman said he's gotten it a lot of times in a row. So... I thought he did some good stuff here, but he should have grabbed that. He could have got the grab. Some close quarter situations, he could be getting get grabs, I feel like. It's a hard part. Like, everything you do, he'll just crouch cancel. Knee, weak knee, crouch cancel. Luckily, he's not getting crazy punishes off it, but, like, that's why it's hard to do stuff. See, Nair, this only worked because of the percent in knockdown, I guess. That could have been... That is crazy. That actually worked. If that was not knockdown percent, that would have not got him a kill. But because it was, it got him a kill. Actually, was I even... I don't think that was knockdown percent. I think he acted. Actually, we can't tell. But I'm gonna... I kind of want to say he did an action and he left crouch cancel. I feel like this worked because it was just it was like a non-fastfold nair, so he probably didn't think the second hit. It was like an awkward interaction. Like, this is the power of, like, if Falcon could knock down Sheik easily with, like, a Nair like this, for example, which this is not the norm, I'll say. But let's say this was the norm, hypothetically. Like, look at this. Get a Nair. Read the option. Knee. Like, that is so powerful. But because it's so hard to get knockdowns on Sheik, and she's so good at crouch canceling at low percent and doing stuff off of it, it's just that's what makes a matchup hard. Because most other characters, like, they don't crouch cancel as much, and, like, it's harder for them to, like, follow up off CCs as easily. See, like, that's actually good. Whenever SJ gets, like, the 0% up air, Plup just crouch cancels it, but since he shielded, he didn't get hit, so I think that was really good. I feel like he did not expect this nair to hit, so he didn't, like, react properly off of it, so that makes sense. He probably just walled with it and didn't expect it to, like, hit like that. Oh, he could have... I think he could have grabbed, I think. Grab. I think that was a grab. I think it was a grab. That kind of sucks. Like, I feel like this punish... What about the after the up air? See, the thing is, he didn't grab after the up air, but I don't blame him because he's used to Plup crouch canceling everything. So this makes sense what he did here. Although if Plup naired here, I wonder if that would have beat the grab. But he didn't. If we look, see, he didn't do anything. So he could have grabbed, but, you know, so that could have been big. Now he's like scrapping, and that's not a good spot. Plup, she can just F tilt you. Oh my gosh, how did that work? Why did that work? Shield. He definitely got a shield. Oh, he jumped? Why? I don't know why, but that knee saved his fucking life. Oh, fuck. Never mind. Oh. That's how good Plup is. He fucking knew to DI down and away. Up air. Honestly, at this point, I was like, alright, he screwed up his punish now. Can you single hit nair this, actually? I wonder if he could single hit nair that. Ooh. Dude, that knee hitting on the right was like huge. I feel like S2J could do more just like run up grabs. Ooh, that's good. That was interesting. I thought it was gonna be like an instant up air or something. Ooh, that up air was good. Did he just slid that off that up B? Edge canceled? Ooh, this is where we need to start air dodging maybe. But at the same time, he's gonna hit it. Even air dodging won't really do much. You do like a perfect wall tech air dodge. There's not much you can really do here. You're just kind of screwed. There might be something, but not obvious at least. Like right there, he could have grabbed. Like he has the opportunity. He just it seems like he's just kind of do. Maybe he's doing a run up crouch cancel. I guess that's all right. But these were definitely like run up grabs sometimes. That's cool. Ooh, was that a shield poke? I think that was a shield poke. That's crazy. I think there should have been a shield drop up air afterwards, but he probably. No, I think he could have expected that to hit. He was clearly going for it. That seemed hard. Oh, that is. What is that? That's like a frame perfect up air, to be fair, so. This is gonna be really hard to fucking hit. That was like a frame perfect up air, basically, so. Yeah, you gotta be really confident in your instant up airs, or you gotta like wait a little longer. Surprised he didn't stomp. He stomps a lot. Oh, there it is. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, the jab reset I think it was a good idea, but he's just at the edge, so it didn't work out too well. He got the double up air, I think. Ooh, yep. You can't really go for knee. It's not really reliable. Oh, what could he have done? Nared? Oh man, that was such a good DI. It's fucking crazy. Are we gonna start instant double jump nairing versus Sheik? That's actually crazy that didn't connect, to be honest. So that is really good by Plup. It's just crazy. There's like the multiple things I've seen that are just like no other Sheik will do. So it's like, how do you? It's just a weird thing to prepare for something when somebody's good enough at stuff that nobody else will do it. So it's not like you're not ready. He basically lost this entire punish. Still got a hit, but he's at low percent. That could have been juicy though off the nair, like a grab or something. So like Plup's DI is just so good. That was good. Get out of there. Oh my gosh. Yeah, Sheik edge guards Falcon so well. This is so crazy how like he jumps perfectly out and like still gets hit by up tilt. Ooh. Ooh. It could have been up air, but sure is much better anyway. Oh my gosh. He has a perfect DI on the nair. I like the up airs. Those are really good. He's playing pretty patient. It's good. How is he? He's like wave dashing right outside the back air spacing. It's interesting. I think he could turn around and grab, but it's close. I'm trying to think if you have time to turn around grab if you stomp at zero. I know if he was already facing, he has time to grab, but his stomp, like, I think he might have time to turn around grab, but it's really close, so maybe that was fine to not do it. At this percent, there's like not much you can really do besides hope they mess up. They just tech chase you, and there's not much counterplay because you're at such a high percent, you can't really like do much else. Oh, that was cool. He just got hit by it, and he was able to get out. See, like basically, you gotta hope for him to mess up. Basically, I think the mistech is good because I think like you have to mix it up at the end of the day, but it's more likely they'll mess up a mistech tech chase most of the time than just tech rolling. I mean, he missed a tech roll in the end, but it started off with a mistech, and I feel like that contributed to it being harder. So he got out. That percent, like you just have to hope, try and be smart with the mix-ups and hope she messes up. So not much you can do. Okay, that should have been a knee. I feel like that was a tech trap. I think that was an obvious tech trap. Maybe he should consider down throwing here. This is actually a really smart DI from Plup because he could barely make it on the play. I think he should have down through. I mean, either way, it's like a mix-up, but he's only down thrown this set in these situations. So I think, I mean, only up thrown. So I think down throw is like a good mix-up there he could do. But it's not like terrible either way, to be honest. But he's playing it good. He's playing it patient, and he's not like forcing stuff. So I think it's really good. Like when he gets in like an uncomfortable situation, he kind of makes sure not to overextend. So I think that's really good so far. Let's see this tech chase. F tilt. Let's see. She cast a mess up. She messed up. It's so weird reacting to stuff like this because, yes, he escaped. Or I guess, okay, he reacted. But it's like, Sheik is so good at keeping pressure. Okay. Oh, man. She covers the corner so well. Ooh, that was good. Those are huge. Like I said, at zero, like, you can only get stomp or grab as true openings. Everything else is kind of just chip damage. I wonder if that was shield grabbable, that back air she Plup did. Okay, that was definitely shield grabbable. Plup messed up. Is he even... That's the thing about Plup. Even when he messes up, he has, like, the perfect, like, cover-up. I guess, like, perfect way to follow up on his mistake. So, like, he just jabs. I mean, it's simple, but, like, I think it's a Sheik thing, too. Like, if you mess up versus... If, like, a other character messed up, you kind of just get out of there, but because Sheik jab, like... And he's, like, he stays on top of him even when he messes up. Makes it a lot harder. But SJ got out. Ooh. Like, dude, the down tilts are doing so much work this set. Seriously. He's gotten, like, three huge openings with down tilt. Stomps are interesting. I don't really do those kind of stomps. Maybe I should. He's playing the scraps really good. That dash tech was... that was probably an aerial, now that I think about it. Yeah, that had to be an aerial. Damn, is that... Ooh. Plup is just dropping the tech chases. Get the mercy of the tech chase. He's playing the scraps super well. Oh my gosh, that up air was perfect. That was such a good up air. That up air was so good. That was... that saved the match. That's crazy. Like, that's the thing. Like, the Sheik doesn't miss the tech chases. Like, it's so brutal. It's hard. The same for Falcon. The problem with Falcons, though, is, like, his is, like, less consistent. Because Sheik's techs are not as reactable. Once you get her to, like, the percent, though. What happened here? Dude, that up tilt just catches the jump sometimes. That was shield grab. Oh, man. That stomp. Unfortunate. Yeah, I like how he's in a defensive spot, he kind of like tries to reset. That seems really good. Rather than trying to like push way in. Oh my gosh. Okay. So actually, a ledge hop back here would have been good, but this is so hard to react to though, to be honest. Like, I guess doing anything is good, because just even getting a hit there is hard to react with in time. Oh, that's actually, I think it's actually amazing, because this is so hard to get a hit on Sheik at low percent. He overshot it so that he's facing the wrong way. Sheik, yeah, that was really good. Can you not? Does that jab reset not work? That was weird. I felt like that should have worked. Dude, he does this again. Okay, he's got these. These are good. I need to do this. These instant stomps after the instant back air from Sheik, those are really good. The down tilts, dude. That was good. I mean, that could have been risky, but I like... Ooh, that should have been grab. That was really good bait. Oh, I like that knee a lot, because he was expecting ledge hop nair. I don't know how I feel about this Nair, because I just feel like he's going to keep holding shield. Like, I would just go for the feet poke with up air or even knee. Actually, knee field poke could be good here. That's good. Oh gosh. Yeah. In a good spot. That's crazy, that knee hit. He's not getting jab grab. That's really good. Everyone got jab grab back in the day. So that's good. He's getting out. This is rough though, because Sheik's at this low percent where you like can barely do anything. Oh, that's, oh my gosh. Crazy. Get some good stomp placements. Ooh. Is he going to die off a nair? Oh no. I would have jab grabbed, but I think I would have worked too, but either way this is like or not guaranteed, so boy. Okay. He played it really good. Alright, I guess that's it. Welcome!